let me know.
All right, whenever you're ready.
Hi there, I'm Emily, aka the Literary Queen, and I'm here to talk to you about Why Did I Ever? By Mary Robison, which is currently out of print, but you can find on Amazon for incredibly cheap, or from your local library or used bookstore. And maybe if we all work together, we'll get this book back in print because it's amazing. I loved Why Did I Ever? It is written in a very weird style where there's these little numbered paragraphs that are little more vignettes or stories. Fans of Lydia Davis would really enjoy this. It's very minimalist. The story is basically about a mother named Money. Well, that's one storyline, and her sort of falling apart life. And then she has two adult children who have both sort of gone through some traumatic experiences that are in the periphery. And it's about the things she just goes through dealing with those children in her life. She also loses a cat halfway through it. I will read you one of my favorite sections called There Is No They. It'll never change, Hollis says beside me in the car. No matter how long we sit here, it'll still be a stop sign. Hollis is a driver's ed instructor. I say, so this is what it must be like to study under you. That's a whole section, just these little funny vignettes. And she drives around at night because she can't really stand to be with herself and gets into all sorts of weird trouble. It's just wonderful. I really, you know, oh, and she gets visits from the IRS. For example, section 120. They leave me with a card that reads, important notice, you were out when we called. It is important that you visit or phone the address or number shown below. This card is not for ID purposes, the IRS. And then section 121, which follows that, is just, huh. It's just very bizarre and very irreverent and really catchy. And I'm so sad this is out of print because it's not a typical novel with a plot. You sort of have to go, things are filled in as you go. You know something horrible happened to the son, but you don't really understand what till the end. And then you're just sort of left with that knowledge. And you can, and she's a, if you work in Hollywood, you're gonna really enjoy this because she is a script doctor. And her take on Hollywood is hilarious. It won the LA Book Prize, LA Times Book Prize in 2001. And this is again, a sad state of affairs at a book that is very well reviewed, then has a giant discarded, as you can see, whoever sold this to me got it for free from the library. That just makes me really sad. For another section, 148, just one sentence, again, like Lydia Davis. Over here in the corner, two of the waiters are sipping from a helium balloon before calling out their food orders. I mean, guys, it's just genius and hilarious. I can't get over it enough. Please read this. And if you hate it, I will, well, no, but I was gonna say I'd buy your copy, but then you could lie and say you read and hated it. But seriously, I just loved this book. I've already bought two copies for other people. So, and if Mary Robinson sees this, good job. You're in the, she's a professor at the University of Southern Mississippi, according to this. But I think she's moved since then. I did a little bit of internet stalking that I've since forgotten. So, check it out. It also deals with drug addiction, which is, you know, interesting to some people and tragic. Yay. Thanks.